Shalom, I'm Kahan Tazadok. Doc. You can now sign up for private group coaching, one-on-one coaching, or couples coaching to include life coaching. So I get both relationship coaching and life coaching and coaching on commerce as far as the secure party creditor, foreclosures, credit card debt, and so on and so forth. So click the link below to register for your session now. Thank you. Let's tune into this very informative video. Whosoever shed last blood by man shall his blood be shed for enmity of Yah. Make he the man destroy all which is evil, so that which is good may flourish, and I shall count thee amongst my favored sheep, and ye shall have the protection of all the angels in heaven. Never shall innocent blood be shed, yet the blood of the wicked shall flow like a river. The three shall spread their black-eyed wings and be the vengeful striking hammer of Yah. Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, you're now under the sounds of the voice of your brother Tazadok Shah Bey, the Undaunted National, the Deprogram Enlightener, because I've been deprogrammed and enlightened. And the intent of this information is not intended for legal advice. It's intended to deprogram you and enlighten you with right knowledge. The information that you're about to receive is very valuable. It is very resourceful. I encourage you to watch this video at least 4 times as a minimum, but 10 times. To have it properly embedded into your subconscious mind so you don't even have to think about it. And if you like this video, please take 2 seconds to like this video and share it. You will help me out a lot. The information I'm about to give you is very valuable, so I want you to share this with your friends and family and as many people as possible, because education, right knowledge, is imperative. It is essential to the future of your children. Now, for the record, I use Federal Reserve Bank publication and the bookkeeping entries as published by the Federal Reserve Bank to actually document all of the material statements in this video that you're about to actually watch. Now, this report actually includes homes or house loans, car loans, and other bank loans and credit card loans where the bank actually recorded the promissory note or receivable as a bank asset as shown in Federal Reserve Bank and publication. Now, bank auditors have actually repeatedly told me that they claim that they credit cash as they record the bank loan agreement, promissory note as a bank asset, which is actually recorded under loan accounts. Now, they told me that they actually redefine words to mean the opposite, thereby significantly changing the meaning, the cause, and the risk of the alleged transaction and agreement. Now I'm giving you the truth. The auditors explain how they actually play with words of art to hide the truth of the real transaction and real agreement. Now, I know you think I'm making this up because so many of you are discombobulated, but I encourage you to listen on. And if you want to understand how to prevent your home from going into foreclosure, or how to deal with it, or how to prevent your car from being taken away from you after you put so much equity in it because they claim you defaulted on a loan, then you want to listen to this video in its entirety. So according to the Chicago Federal Reserve Bank publication and Modern Money Mechanics, page 6, I'm giving you where you could go to get it. And I hope you should be writing this down. The bank records the promissory note as a bank asset, which is actually offset by a new bank liability called the borrower's transaction account, which is commonly called a checking account, to be frank. Now, I want you to note that the word borrower is possessive. It's possessive. Now, page 3 of that same report, second column and second paragraph, claims that the banks create new money as loans are granted. Now, if you read the page, they redefined the word money. They redefined the word money to mean own money, which is the opposite of money. Do you understand? So the idea is that if you deposit $100 of cash into a checking account, are you with me? Do you follow me? There is an equal amount of money, cash, deposited to match the bank liability. Now, according to GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles, a bank liability means that the bank actually owes money and cash. Money is actually recorded as a bank asset. So a check is not money. Make no mistake about it. A check is not money, but acts like money with the presumption that money is first deposited to make the check good. And according to Black Law's dictionary, a check contains an unconditional promise to pay a sum certain in money. So the presumption is that if you present a check to the bank teller will give you cash. See, these people operate under presumption and assumptions. We've been telling you that for years. So the Federal Reserve Bank of Texas, for instance, money publication, Banking and Monetary Policy, explains on page 11 that the bank creates money when they lend it. So the loan becomes a new deposit into the customer's checking account, just like a payroll check does. So Federal Reserve Bank of Boston publication, Banking Basic Publication, page 1, claims that the money deposited belongs to the depositors. They claim that the money deposit belongs to the depositors. Well, Federal Reserve Bank of the great state of New York publication, the story of bank page 10 claims that the bank first deposits the money and then uses the deposited money to make loans. Do you follow me? So then it claims that a lot of money is actually created when the bank, credit unions, and savings loans make new loans. That's what they claim. Now, the Federal Reserve Bank of Chicago publications A, B, and C's of the figuring entrance page 2 claims, they claim that when you deposit money into a savings account, you make a loan to the bank. But according to GAAP, the new banking liability proves a loan to the bank. Follow me. So when we look at Black Law's dictionary, Black Law's dictionary explains that a deposit as placing money in the custody of a bank. to be withdrawn at the will of the depositor. That's what a deposit is. So the Federal Reserve Bank of New York publications, I bet you thought, explains it very well on page 27, that the bank creates new money whenever they grant loans by simply depositing the borrower's promissory note as a bank asset offset by a new bank liability. And page 5 explains that the money does not have to be issued by the government or be in any special form. Are you listening to me? Oh, I hope that you're listening. Now, I want you to combine that with the Federal Reserve Bank that I actually just mentioned prior to that, and with the Federal Reserve Banks who've actually admitted in writing, and you have the facts that the bank used the borrower's promissory note as money or like money. So, brothers, sisters, ladies, gents, hereafter, call money, deposit it, or record it as a bank access to give value to a check. To give value to a check, which the bank returns to the borrower as a loan. So when the bank deposited money or the promissory note, the money deposited was a loan to the bank. Now, this is consistent with GAAP and matching the principle. So bank auditors repeatedly told me, because I questioned them, that they must hide the loan to the bank. Now, if the loan to the bank is hidden, then you have the economics similar to stealing. Yet, they're throwing many of you in jail over petty crimes, running a traffic light, not paying a ticket, not paying your so-called child support, when you have these banksters that's swindling millions from the people. It's promissory notes. So what they're doing is similar to stealing. It's similar to counterfeiting and swindling. But who's jailing these banksters? They're controlling the black robes and lawyers. So all we ask for is that the party who funded the loan, per the bank bookkeeping interest, be repaid the money. That's all we're asking for. So what honest person would argue against that? Only a mischievous devil would. So if one argues that one who actually funded the loan per the bookkeeping interest should not be repaid the money, then they are arguing that one of the parties has a right to swindle the other party. Simple and plain. Do you follow me? So my question is this. It's just a question. What law or agreement gives the party the right to swindle the other party? Show me the law. I don't want to hear your debate. Show me the law. So show me. I don't think just Tazadok Sharbe alone wants to know. Americans all over wants to know. So if the bank cannot answer, they lost the argument by acquiescence, by silence. So now I will explain what bank auditors have asked, because I've been doing some research on this and asking them, writing them and asking them. So I will explain what bank auditors has actually told me in their response and some of the lies and smoke and mirrors. And then I will try and expose this misinformation before my channel is shut down again. But bank auditors cannot give a complete answer as to what money is. They can't. So to be a CPA, one must have the competence to actually complete the assignment. And if one they cannot answer what money is, they have no right to audit the books or testify. Do you understand? Do you understand? So typically, bank auditors will actually claim that the promissory note is not money and that the bank did not deposit money received from the borrower, and the borrower did not make a deposit at the bank or the credit union. I hope you're understanding what I'm saying here. So then they claim that the two loans were not exchanged. Now, typically, at this time, they go through the motions that the GAAP follow, and everything is in order, just like, you know, Arthur Anderson did just before the audit fraud was exposed. They follow me. So then the typical bank or credit union auditors use the following example that auditors have probably written back and explained to me when I backed them up in a corner. Is actually a trick to deceive the judge and the general population. And, you know, I'm going to first get the trick and then expose the trick. So the trick is this, folks, and you should be writing this down. And by the way, this video is extremely valuable. So at the conclusion of this video, because I encourage you to watch it in its entirety, click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this video to be worth. $200, $100, $50, $5, $10. Or, I mean, if you are of that character, just a dollar. Because this video could very well prevent your home from foreclosure. It may save your home and save all of your equity. So, the trick is this. It goes like this. The bank does not deposit the promissory note. The bank or the credit union records the promissory note or the credit card purchase as an asset on the books of the bank or the credit union and credit cash to balance the books. It's all about balancing the books. So, the borrower got cash. So, this is exactly what one bank auditor explained to me and admitted that it is a fraud. It is a fraud and a lie. Now, at the same time, and I'm not going to give this person's information. No, I'm not going to give it. And at this time, you know, the typical bank and credit union auditor will try and avoid explaining that the cash earlier credited is now deposited. So the deposit is a debit to cash and a credit to a bank liability, like a checking account or a demand deposit account or a savings account. Do you understand? Do you understand? So the new results is exactly what the Federal Reserve Bank has already admitted. There is a new bank asset and a new bank liability. So the new asset came from the borrower, and the bank liability means that the bank owes money related to the new asset. Do you understand? So in the previous mentioned bookkeeping entries that I went over earlier, where the bank auditors actually claim that they credit cash, they can replace the word cash with the word check, and you will have the same economics and bookkeeping entries on the typical loan. So the trick is that they use is that a check and a cash are similar because you could get cash for a check. Now, as I mentioned earlier, a check is not cash. According to black law, a check is not cash, but a promise to pay a certain sum of money, according to black law's dictionary. So, the thing is, folks, few people use cash. Most use checks. And the auditor knows this, but not Tommy Doc Sharp, eh? So, they can sell the promissory note for cash. So logic tells us that the auditor is wrong here, claiming that they gave you cash. And you're so discombobulated, you believe it. So the bank or the credit union auditor must agree that the promissory note is recorded as a bank asset, typically recorded under the loan account. So if the offset or the credit is to cash or check, then the typical borrower deposits the cash or check, resulting in a debit to cash or a check and an offset to the bank or the credit union liability, typically called a checking account, demand deposit account, or a savings account. And the result is exactly what the Federal Reserve Bank publication earlier stated, that it is a new bank asset and a new bank liability, and the economics are the same or similar to depositing new money. So I, Tazza Doc Sharp Bay, an agreed man, challenge any bank or credit union auditor to prove what I just set forth as wrong. See, they either remain silent and acquiescent or try and get off on another subject to confuse the issue. Now, some of these auditors are stupid enough to keep the game going by foolishly, derangedly claiming that no money was actually deposited to cover the check, and thus admitting to a criminal act of check needing. And a fraudulent audit. So some pretend that the promissory note is the first solid for cash. Now, the cash deposited to give value to the check, and the promissory note is actually recorded as a bank asset. So this is a simple, stupid argument, because the result is actually a brand new asset and a new bank liability, just as I stated earlier. Do you understand? So in all of the information that I just presented to you, brothers and sisters, about these bank cases, the bank or the credit union got the promissory note for free. New money, credit, or money equivalent was created. So the party who actually provided the assets, you, the party that provided the assets, to give value to the check that is claimed to be lent. It is claimed to be lent to the alleged buyer was the same alleged buyer, you, and the party who funded the loan, you. Don't you get this? Like, they're taking your homes. They're taking your cars. Oh, you defaulted on a car loan. I'm going to come and get it. So, per the bookkeeping entrance, is not repaid the money. You're not repaid the money. It was your promissory note. Do you get it? What is a dollar? It is a promissory note. It is a promise to pay. So, this creates the economic similar to stealing, counterfeiting, or swindling. So, this changes the cause and the risk of the loan compared to if one who actually funded the loan is repaid the money. You funded the loan, you should be repaid the money. Do you understand? Your signature. Do you get it? Are you getting this now? Do you see where I'm going with this? Or what they've been doing to you, the people? Do you understand? So, Tazza Doc Sharp challenges any auditor under the sound of my voice right now to prove that the economics are not similar to stealing, counterfeiting, or swindling, and that the GAAP principle of matching was not applied by matching the new asset with a bank liability, actually showing that the bank owes money to the alleged borrower, you, for your home, for your car, for your credit card, as indicated in the Federal Reserve Banking publication. So the matching principle works like this, folks. I'm not going to take up too much more of your time. I hope you're writing this down, or you need to watch this video 10 times to get this into your subconscious mind, because your homes are being taken away from you. They're destroying your lives because you folks don't want to study and research. But Tazadok Shabe is in your midst today. Let's continue on. So, the matching principle works like this. If you deposit $100 of cash at the bank must show a bank liability of $100, showing that the bank must return the $100 to you. Understand that. So if the bank accepts cash or a promissory note from you to give value to a check, should not the same economics apply to stop the economics similar to stealing? Just a question. Counterfeiting and swindling? Should not the party who funded the loan per the bookkeeping entrance be repaid the money? The bank or the credit union auditors cannot discuss this issue, which is the heart of the whole discussion. Why can't they discuss the issue? See, we have a right to know and understand the entrance agreement and the economics and bookkeeping entrance. It's all about balancing the books, folks. So Tazadok Shabe is looking to force a bank auditor into a court deposition and force the bank auditors to give all of the details of the bookkeeping entries, explain what is and what is not money equivalent, and credit, and explain the economics of the transaction. That's what I want. That's what you should want as well. You see, the bank or the credit union wrote the agreement. They executed the bookkeeping entries, and we have a right to know and understand what the agreement is and the economics of the agreement. One question remains. What is that question? Is the party who provided the asset that gave value to the alleged bank loan check per the bookkeeping interest to be repaid an equal amount of value for the value that was earlier provided to fund the loan, the check? Now, if the answer is no, do you agree that this is a swindle? It's a question. If the bank can get money or an asset for free from the buyer, or still, better choice of words, it by knowingly hiding the full terms of the agreement, a contract, a law, wait, law is contract, of the contract, and then return the money to the victim as a loan, because that's what they're doing to you with your homes. You've already paid the home off, if you understand what I'm saying to you here. If, you know, you're a victim as a loan, then they could own nearly everything in the nation similar to the economics of counterfeiting. And this, folks, has what's been occurring. So, folks, demand, for educational purposes, demand the auditors produce the bookkeeping entries to prove the promissory note is not used to give value to the check and that the depositor's money was actually used to fund the loan. So if this were the case, the bookkeeping entries would be a debit to a checking account or demand deposit account or savings account and credit to cash. So the promissory note would not be recorded as the bank asset. The depositors cannot spend the money taken out of the bank account, which was actually lent to the borrower. The borrower repays the loan, and the money is returned to the party who funded the loan. Now, economically speaking, everyone has equal protection. There are no economics similar to stealing, counterfeiting, and swindling. There is only one key issue. According to the bookkeeping entries, should the value of the money or the asset that was used to fund or give the value to the loan be returned to the original party who actually provided the money or asset? It's a question. If the CPA auditor says no, then we have economics of a swindle. If the CPA auditor says yes, then there is no disagreement. There's no disagreement, and we all agree. Now, we could possibly argue that the one who actually funded the loan should not be repaid the money unless they're actually trying to create economics similar to a swindle. Now, they would have to actually hide the true bookkeeping entries if this were the case. So, if so, have the auditor give the complete details of the bookkeeping entries, including who provided the access to fund the loan. And if the CPA cannot explain or does not understand what we are actually asking about or talking about, then he or she does not have the competence to take on an audit assignment and has broken the ethicals or the ethics of the CPA. Have the bank or the credit union CPA auditor give all examples of things that banks use as 1. Money, 2. Money equivalent, 3. Things of value that gives value to, like a check, is money. Have them recorded as a bank asset or liability. Have they done that? Is cash money? Does the bank use a note as money? Is the promissory note used to give value to check or similar instruments? Is it the intent of the bank policy that the party who actually provided the asset to give the loan check per bookkeeping entries? Have the money or the value of the asset earlier described returned to them? Is that the intent? If a CPA cannot answer these simple questions, folks, then the ethics discuss that they have no business auditing the bank or credit union. So the CPA has an auditor, must have the competence to answer these simple questions if they took on the assignment to audit the bank or the credit union. Now, if they claim that they follow the GAAP, have them give detailed answers and to answer these questions that Tyler Doc Sharpe has prevented in this video. And will the CPA claim that the Federal Reserve Bank publications are wrong? Examine, folks, examine what the CPA says and see if they refuse to answer the basic questions that I presented in this video to determine the bank's policies, economics of a loan, and what the full bookkeeping entries of the GAAP really are. And if the bank CPA disagrees to have and give the proof, if no proof, they have no credibility. They have no credibility. So, you know, when CPA auditor could be taking a class or something, just learning this stuff, you know. Folks, have the bank or the credit union auditors prove that the Federal Reserve banking publications are incorrect and that money is not first deposited and then lent out. You know, have them prove that the intent of the agreement is that the party who actually provided the access to fund the loan per the bookkeeping entries is not to be repaid money or the value of the access that funded the loan. See, there is only one real issue to be resolved. Ask the bank or the credit union CPA auditor to answer the following questions. Is it the basic intent of the loan agreement that whichever party provided the access to give the value to the loan according to the bookkeeping entries is to be repaid back with equal amount of value plus interest when the loan is repaid? It's a question. This is a very simple and basic concept any competent CPA should understand. And if, folks, the borrower actually funded the loan to the borrower should be actually repaid. So if someone other than the borrower funded the loan, then the party who actually funded the loan should be repaid the money. That's very simplistic. Now, we must decide per the bookkeeping entries if the borrower funded the loan. So if the borrower provided cash or a check or an asset that the book that the bank actually deposited or used to give value to the loan, then the bank assets and liabilities will increase. Now, I challenge the bank auditors to prove me wrong. If the bank lent other depositors money and did not accept an asset from the borrower to fund the loan or give value to the loan, then the net overall banking asset and liabilities from the transaction would actually increase. Am I correct? You follow me? So I challenge any bank auditor to prove me wrong. So this just actually told you who funded the loan, folks. So according to GAAP, the Federal Reserve Banking Publication, the net effect of the total transaction of the bookkeeping entries was the net banking asset and liability increase. And I challenge any CPA bank auditor to prove me wrong. The CPA can play with words of art, ignore the issues, beat around the bush, and talk about nothing of importance. But if they do and refuse to prove me wrong, you know everything that you need to know and how to win now. So folks, typically, the bank auditors will go into great detail on how they follow the GAAP and belong to all the bank societies, organizations, and so on and so forth, and even the AICPA. Now, this is all a bunch of meaningless chatter if they can actually not agree on one simple concept of the GAAP called the matching principle. See, the matching principle means that if a bank accepts an asset from Tyler Dock. The bank must offset the asset by a bank liability showing that the bank owes Tyler Dock money. So the bank cannot accept the asset from Tyler Dock, refuse to show it, owes Tyler Dock the asset. So the bank received from Tyler Dock and then claimed that the bank owes Elliot the equal value from the asset instead of Tyler Dock. So the matching principle stops swindle. Do you understand? Do you understand? Had the bank or the credit union CPA auditors prove that Tyler Dock is wrong concerning this? Have them prove it. So, folks, to end this video of the GAAP matching principles, the CPA auditors will try and claim that you, crook, or that you credited, should I say, that you credited cash and not a liability account. So the net result, no matter what, or no matter how you look at it, you know, no matter how you crook the books, is a new bank liability once the promissory note is actually recorded as an asset or the credit union posts charges to the credit card's holder's loan account. So the Federal Reserve Bank publication shows that the matching principle claims that the two loans were exchanged as is, correct per the GAAP matching principles. So if two loans were not exchanged, then there is a tax owed to the IRS for the stolen promissory note. Do you understand? Do you understand? Now, did the bank pay the IRS tax? So the matching principle does not allow anyone to steal your asset. Follow me. So exchange it for something of equivalent value and return the value stolen to the victim of the loan. So the bank auditors who actually claim that cash or a check was actually credit in exchange for the promissory note, which is actually recorded as an asset, got the promissory note for free and exchanged the value of the promissory note for a check and returned the check to the victim as a loan. As a loan, having economics similar to deposited promissory note like money, which allows the bank to get the promissory note for free and create new money. This is what's happening with your homes. This is how they are able to come and take your homes with foreclosure. So the economics are like the bank is acting as a money charger and calling it a loan. So if the bank took your cash or stole the cash and used the cash to fund a check and return the check to you as a loan, you can understand it is like stealing. Replace the word cash with promissory note and you will have similar economics. Do you understand? Understand that. So claiming that cash or a check was credited is only a smokescreen. It's only a mirror. And it only mirrors accounting and crooking the books, which give the economics similar to stealing, counterfeiting, and swindling. Have the bank CPA auditor prove me wrong. Have them prove me wrong. So if Tyler Dock signs a promissory note and it is actually agreed that Tyler Dock loaned the promissory note to the bank, then the following bookkeeping entries are recorded. The promissory note is recorded as a bank asset and the bank's records or the bank records a bank liability showing that the bank owes Tyler Dock money for the loan to the bank. So this shows two loans were exchanged, as proven by the new asset and the new liability. So under the smoke screen, under the mirror mention, the bank records the promissory note as an asset, resulting in a new bank liability when everything is actually completed. But this time, Tyler Dot loan were not exchanged. So the bank got the promissory note for free, as the bank created new money. And the party who actually funded the loan, per the bookkeeping entries, is not repaid the money. This is what's going on when you purchase a home. You pay for it up front with the promissory note. So have any bank CPA auditor prove me wrong. A bank auditor hiding this must claim they credited cash or check. But when the cash or the check is deposited, you have new asset and new liability. So this temporary bookkeeping entry only hides the true transactions and economics. So a check is a liability, and who gets a handful of bugs in cash when they get a car or a house loan? Who gets it? As the bank CPA auditors, many of them, has responded to my letters, it is a lie that the cash was credited. It was only cool cash to get everyone off track, as the true nature of the true economics. So the bank auditors typically call cash things other than cash to hide the true meaning of the word. Do you understand? Do you understand? The bank auditors, many have admitted to me that it was a lie that the true party who funded the loan, per the bookkeeping entries, has never repaid the money. The auditors have mentioned to me that there is a new asset and liability, and liability means that the bank owes money for the asset it accepted as an asset. This, folks, is the basics, GAAP. So the bank got the promissory note for free by creating new money and violating the GAAP principle of matching. Then, when you ask the bank or bank auditor for the truth, they typically misrepresent how it works or refuse to explain. And with that, folks, I'm going to bring this video to an end for now, and I trust that you've learned something from this video, and I trust that you found it of value. And if you did find this video of value, click the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you found this to be worth. $200, $100, $50, $10, even $1. After all, I may have just saved you from foreclosure. If you listen to this video in its entirety, and if you clearly understand it, or if you need personal coaching, click the email link below the video. Just read below the video. You'll see it. And someone will actually be in contact with you as promptly as possible. Or if you would like to become a secured party creditor to undergo the redemption process properly, click the email link below the video, and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible if you want to get up from out under the sewer. Become a secured party creditor. Click the email link below and get into contact with us. So until next time, Tyler Doc Shabe is saying shalom.
Be certain to tune in every Monday at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for the Truth Will Make You podcast. We will discuss commercial issues. And every Wednesday, 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we will discuss relationship issues. Be sure to tune in. And if you'd like to be a guest on our podcast, to come down to the Taj Mahal Content Creation Room, email kahantazadoc7@gmail.com. That's kahantazadoc7@gmail.com. See you there.